like the postman, he always delivers. It's Vernon Kay.
To All Star Family Fortunes, a show where we ask 100 people a range of everyday questions. Now, this week we asked 100 roofers, who do you celebrate at night if you've already spent a day on the tiles? Good question. Now, the aim of the game is very simple. Two families have got to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out, get them right, and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice. But get them wrong, and they'll hear this. We've got two families shaking like leaves, but which one's going to end up raking in the cash? The head of our first family is an actress who starred as a newspaper editor in the recent ITV hit drama Broadchurch. But will she be making headlines tonight? It's Carolyn Pickle! It's a real pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you for coming on with your family.
Great pleasure.
Where have you brought the family from?
Well, your side of the Pennines, Vernon. Oh, one nice. From Manchester and the rest from North London.
We'll take that. We'll take that. Please introduce me to your family.
So, my sweet pickle family, my daughter, Hetty.
Hi, Hetty.
Hi, Vernon.
My daughter's boyfriend, Jason.
Hi, Jason. Hi,
Vernon. My nephew, Matthew.
Hi, Matt.
Hello, Vernon.
And my niece, Lucy.
Hi, Lucy.
Hi, Vernon.
Now then, she may come from a family of pickles, but will she find herself in a jam here?
Breaking news.
So tell me, how do you feel about your Family Fortunes debut?
Family Fortunes? Well, I can't wait to meet Vernon.
Extra, extra. Read all about it.
Hi, I'm Hetty, Carolyn's daughter. Welcome to her house in London. Come inside.
Carolyn has appeared in loads of popular TV shows. She starred as Shelley Williams in Emmerdale. DCI Kim Reid in The Bill. And is a reporter in the hit TV drama Broadchurch.
Now that's definitely something to write home about.
Carolyn loves dancing in the kitchen to Coldplay.
And I will try to fix you.
Sounds like someone needs to fix her voice.
She's also got a massive crush on Paul McCartney.
Carolyn is multi-talented and speaks Russian,
Dratsvitska,
French,
Bonjour,
and Spanish.
Hola.
She also loves to do the can-can.
She can she?
Oh, yes, she can.
Mom has appeared in feature films like Ali G.
Boyakasha.
She played Camilla Parker Bowles in Prince William.
Anyone for tea?
And met a very slippery end as she was eaten by a snake in Harry Potter.
No!
We won't be getting into a pickle tonight.
We will just relish beating the opposition.
Come on, the pickle!
Now, you've recently starred in the ITV drama Broadchurch.
Yes.
So what we thought we'd do is we thought we would make up our very own very own copy of the Broadchurch Echo.
Oh.
With the front page reeling Carolyn Pickles and Family Peer on All Star Family Fortunes.
Oh, fantastic.
You can keep that.
Keep that with pride.
Yeah. Don't use it as a fire lighter.
No.
Now then, what charity are you playing for tonight, Carolyn?
I'm playing for Interact, which is a charity that helps rehabilitate stroke patients in hospitals.
All right, well, good luck.
Thank you.
£30,000 is our jackpot tonight. We wish you all the very best of luck. Give them a big round of applause for Pickles! So you need two families for Family Fortunes. Let's see who they're playing against. The head of our next family is a real-life EastEnder. He supports West Ham, and he's about to come down the Owls and Peels. Please give it up for Perry Fenwick! Where are you writing your family from?
But my family's from the East End of London. Where else?
All right, Perry, please introduce me to your family.
This is my mum, Diane.
Hi, Diane.
Hello, Vernon.
This is my sister, Tracy.
Hi, Tracy.
Hi, Vernon.
My brother, Lee.
Hi, Vernon.
And my nephew, Connor.
Hi, Connor.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, he drinks in the Queen Vic on Albert Square, but is he the king of the castle at home? Let's find out.
I'm Diane and I'm Perry's mum. This is where he comes to chill out in my house in Essex. So if you fancy a cup of tea, come on in.
Perry's probably best known for playing Billy Mitchell in EastEnders. But one of his proudest moments was when he ran for Albert Square with a torch. Not that torch, this torch!
Oh, thanks. When Perry was little, he always wanted to be a...
Doctor?
No.
Fireman?
No, he wanted to be a...
Finman?
That's rubbish.
Perry's always been a huge fan of football, even once had trials for Leighton Orient.
Now, he's the biggest West Ham supporter in the world. When a baby's born into our family, the first thing he does is goes out and buys it a West Ham bib and baby grow, regardless if it's a boy or a girl.
But I want him to be an Arsenal supporter.
Perry loves to unwind after a hard day's work with a little bit of karaoke.
Welcome to the house of fun, now I've come of age. Welcome to the house of fun.
Keep the noise down, this is complete madness.
Perry is one of the nation's most loved soap stars.
So tonight we're hoping to clean up
and win the big money on Family Fortune.
Come on in, family!
So Perry, just talk us about the fact that you didn't want to be a doctor or a fireman. You want to be a bin man.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it was because I just thought that you could find things in the road. I don't know why.
Rummaging through the rubbish.
Yeah, I didn't really want to work. I just wanted to find money, you know?
Fair enough. Speaking of money, what charity are you playing for tonight?
Tonight we're playing for Cancer Research, Vernon.
All right, well, wish you all the very best of luck. With a big round of applause, the Fenwicks! Right, we've got our families and I've got the questions at the ready, but will our families deliver the goods? Caroline and Perry, come and join me as we play Family Fortunes. The first round of single money, every point's worth a pound. We surveyed 100 people, we're looking for the top six answers. Name a musical instrument you could not fit in your car. Perry.
Tuba.
A tuba. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Unlucky. Unlucky. Yeah. Caroline, what do you think?
Grand piano.
Oof, yeah. Good answer. Yes, good answer. Yeah. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Top answer. Yay. We're going to play. All right, Harry, go back to your family, start conferring. Let's come to you, Hetty. What do you think? Name a musical instrument you cannot fit in the car.
A harp.
A harp. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Good, yes, yeah, second most popular answer. Well done. Jason, what do you think?
Drums.
The drums. Our survey says... Yes! Drum kit. It's going to get a little bit more difficult now because only 12 people said drum kit. We're looking for three more answers, got three lives left. Matt, what do you think?
What sort of car are we talking?
Oh, let's not get technical. Let's not get technical, Matt.
I'll go double bass, please, Brennan.
Double bass. All right, double bass. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yes! Nice, Matt. Not only is your answer on the board, but you've won a spot prize.
Ah!
Yes, take a look. Well, don't cheer just yet, Caroline.
Sorry,
because you never know when it could be.
Terrible.
Well done. Let's have a look. This is coming on with you tonight, Matt.
This prize will leave you feeling hot, 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 Matt, as you've just bagged yourself an all-inclusive luxury holiday to Mexico. Courtesy of icelolly.com, you'll be jetting off to enjoy this Central American paradise. Whether you just want to lounge on the gorgeous beaches, take in the local heritage, or dare to sample the local delicacies. But don't worry, there'll be something to suit all your tastes. Scorchio!
Mexico, Matt.
Fantastic.
Yeah, really good. Who are you going to take with you?
Well, if she'll go with me after watching that VT with me in a can-can outfit, probably my girlfriend, shall
I? Oh, that's the right answer. Well done. Right, Lucy, what do you think? Name a musical instrument you could not fit in your car.
I think a church organ.
Good, yeah.
Can you imagine trying? A church organ. Our survey says...
Yes!
Yeah! Well done! We have a chance now to get a full board without losing any lives.
Oh,
but unfortunately, the pressure's come to you.
I'm going to say, because I have a friend who I've never seen her take it in the car, the cello.
The cello. All right. Bit dubious in the studio audience. Mark, what are you thinking? Cello?
I'm happy with cello.
Cello?
Are you all happy?
Yeah?
Mm.
Yeah? All right. Jason, you've got no opinion whatsoever tonight because you're going out with Hetty. Whatever ever goes, happens.
That's it.
You just nod your head. That's all you've got to do. All right, let's have a look. We're looking for the cello. Our survey says... Oh, yes! Wow! Excellent! That is amazing! I feel ever so proud when people get a full board without losing any lives. Oh. Well done. At the end of the first round, the Fenwick family have no points, didn't get a chance to play, let's be honest. But in the lead with 95 points, it's the Pickles! So join us after the break for more Family Fortunes! All-Star Family Fortunes. Tonight is actress Carolyn Pickles and her family against Perry Fenwick and his family. Now, both are used to the limelight, but which one will end up looking like a lemon tonight? So far, it's no points to the Fenwicks. And in the lead with 95, it's the Pickles family. All right, Hetty and Diane, come and join me. Let's continue playing Family Fortunes. Hetty.
Hello.
Good luck to you both, ladies. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Here we go. Single money, every point's worth a pound. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top six answers. Name something people do to try and stop themselves laughing. Diane.
Hold themselves in.
Right. Right, stop yourself out. Stop yourself going
yeah,
in.
Just, yeah.
I know what you mean. Stop yourself wetting yourself.
Yeah.
I know what you mean. Let's have a look. Our survey says...
I'm sorry.
I love you for that answer. Stop yourself having a wee. Hetty, what do you think?
Put your hand on your mouth.
Put your hand on your mouth?
Yeah.
Have you ever done that?
Yeah.
All right. Put your hand on your mouth. All right. Our survey says... Oh, well done. Well done. Now, you've got control of the board. We like to play our pass.
Yeah.
We're going to play it. All right. Diane, go back to your family. Start confirming. You might get a chance to steal. Superb. Superb. What a gem. All right, Jason. What do you think?
What Perry was doing then, biting his lip.
Biting his lip? Oof, give it away, Perry. Biting his lip. Let's see if it's there, Jason. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yes, well done. That's third most popular answer. Matt.
Think of something sad or dark.
Goodness gracious me. He's already got actor's problems. Taking himself to a dark place. Stop himself laughing. All right, Matt. Our survey says... Yes, it's there! Think of something sad! Well done. Well done, Matt. Lucy on the end, what do you think?
Get some fresh air.
Excuse me, I'm just going to laugh. Get some fresh air. All right. Let's have a look. You go outside, get some fresh air. Our survey says... you know what makes it even worse, Lucy, is because this show's recorded, you're probably sat at home right now with all your mates, with your popcorn, your fizzy drinks, watching it on a big telly, and they've just seen you say that answer.
Thanks.
And right now they're mocking you in your own front room!
Thanks, Vernon.
Can you believe it?
He stole my answer.
Yes.
I'm afraid.
I've had that excuse a million times.
And it still works, doesn't it?
It does. Well done. Well done.
Thanks.
Well done. All right. Caroline, we're looking for three answers. We've got two lines left. So we're doing all right. We're doing all right. Name something people do to try and stop themselves from laughing.
Well, I've been on stage when people have tried to corpse me, but I couldn't do what I'm going to say, which is put my head in a bucket of water when I was on stage. So, but I think that's if I wasn't on stage. Right. I might try and immerse myself in water.
Right. Is everything all right in your family?
Just about.
I'll
tell you later.
Oh, goodness. All right, she's stepping outside for fresh air. He's going, taking himself to a dark place. You're diving in water. Goodness gracious me. All right, let's have a look. Our survey says... Oh, it's not. It's not, though. All right, Hetty, come on. What do you think?
Hold your breath.
You hold your breath. Ooh. Well done. A normal answer didn't get any reaction from our studio audience. There you go. Hold your breath. Let's see if it's there. If it's not there, Fenwick family, get ready. You're going to get the chance to steal. Our survey says... You've won a spot prize. Take a look at this. It's coming home with you tonight.
Ring, ring. I think it's for you, Hetty, as you've just bagged yourself a brand new mobile. Thanks to handtech.co.uk, you can trade in your old model and be the proud owner of this state-of-the-art handset. With one touch, you'll be able to surf the web, listen to music, take pictures, or just have a good old natter. Text-tastic.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
No problem, no problem. Jason, what do you think, my friend? You're on your last life, you need two more answers. Name something people do to try and stop themselves laughing.
Pinch yourself.
Pinch yourself. All right. You're into the pain thing, you, aren't you? Bite yourself, no, pinch yourself. Let's have a look. Our survey says, get ready, Fenwick. If it's not there, we're coming to you. Our survey says... It is there! Well done. Good luck. Good lad. How long have you been together?
2 years.
No, we know why, because he's a bright lad. He's a bright lad. Right, we need one more answer. Matthew, it's up to you. You've got one life left. What do you think, big dog?
There's a lot on this. Turn it into a cough.
Turn it into a cough?
Mm.
Right. Good for that. We're looking for the 6 most popular answer for a full board. If it's not there, it's your final life. We're going to go over to the Fenwicks. You said turn it into a cough. Our survey said...
Oh!
Wow! Amazing! Neil Pratt, well done.
Oh,
well done, the Pickles. At the end of round two, it's no points to the Fenwick family against 183 to the Pickles family. Wow. All right, Jason, Tracy, come and join me. Let's play the final round of Single Money. Jason, one hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your backs. Good luck to you both. Here we go. It's the final round of Single Money. Every point's worth a pound. We're looking for the top 6 answers. Name a kind of match. Jason.
Football.
Football match. If this is up there, it'll be your 3rd answer that you found on the board in a row, which is pretty darn good. Well done. He's all right. See, I approve. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yes, top answer. We're going to let them have a go. All right, we're going to pass. All right, you go back. Go back to your family, start conferring. We're going to pass. We're going to pass.
All right.
Well done. Nice lad. What do you think, Lee? Name a kind of match.
What about a safety match, Vern?
Safety match, yes. A match that you liked. Our survey says... Yes, well done. Safety match. Second most popular answer. Connor, what do you reckon?
Tennis.
A tennis match. Good lad, yeah, tennis match. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Oh! prize. Well done, son. Here we go. Look at this. It's coming on with you tonight. You've not won the holiday because Matt's already got it, but let's see what else you've won.
This prize is Fast and Furious, Connor. Courtesy of Treat Me, you'll be hitting the racetrack for a supercar driving experience that'll really get your heart racing. Get set to burn rubber in the likes of Lamborghinis, Ferraris and Aston Martins. Buckle up and get into gear because this will be a road trip that you'll never forget. Vroom, vroom.
Well done, Colin. Good stuff. Congratulations. Right. Perry, how long have you been in showbiz?
Showbiz? Oh, yeah. Blimey.
How long have you been on EastEnders?
15 years.
15 years. And before that, what were you doing before that?
All sorts. Loads and loads.
We know you were doing all sorts.
No, you don't do this.
Yeah.
What are you going to do, then?
Oh, Perry.
Yeah. No. We're losing. We haven't won nothing.
Don't worry, my friend. Don't worry, my friend. Because you know, there's a lot of people, like myself included, we started off catalogue modelling.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Look, take a look, ladies and gentlemen. Nice. Looking good. Looking real good. All right, so what we're going to do, Perry, you and I, it's been a lifelong ambition of mine to hit the catwalk with your good self. So there's some glasses for you. Let's open the doors and get some jackets. Yes, come on. Let's recreate the moment. What year was this, Perry?
I don't know, about 1980.
1980. Right, we've got some music, so we're going to catwalk.
The last shred of credibility I've ever had has gone down the tent.
Is that it? Yeah, nice. Yeah. Nice. All right, cue the music. Cue the music. Come on, Perry. I like it. Look at that. Mum, you must have been proud of this.
Yeah, I was.
All right, so, Perry, what do you think after all that catwalk modelling? Name a kind of match.
Cricket.
Cricket match. Yes, good answer. All right, we've got all three lives intact. We're looking for three answers. Cricket match. Yes, good man. Good man. We need two more answers. Diane, what do you think? Name a kind of match. We've had football match, safety match, cricket test match, or a tennis match.
Netball match.
Netball match. Good. Let's see if it's up there. Our survey says. It's not. Unlucky. Unlucky. What do you think, Chris?
Basketball.
Basketball match, yes, OK. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Get ready, Pickles family, you might get a chance to steal. Lee.
Chess, Vern.
Chess match. Very popular in the audience. Chess match, yes. Football, safety, cricket, tennis, chess. No, unlucky. All right, Luce, what do you think?
Rugby.
Matt?
Love match.
Speaking of which, Jason?
Rugby. I'll go for
Hetty?
Rugby.
Now, Carolyn, you can have one of those answers,
I've
or you can have,
one.
You can have one of your own.
I'm tempted for love, but I think rugby.
You're going to go rugby match? For the steal from the Fenwicks? Rugby match. Is it the third or sixth most popular answer? Our survey says... Yeah! Well done, team. Let's take a look at the sixth most popular answer. The one we were looking for was... You're quite good at this game, Matthew. What do you do for a living, Matt?
I work as a press officer for a university.
Oh, really? Spend all your day online playing family football. Yeah, that's all he does. Well done. So, at the end... of round three, it's no points to the Fenwicks. But 275 to the Pickles, come on! After the break, we'll be playing Double Money. See you in a few. to Family Fortunes. Tonight is actress Carolyn Pickles and her family against actor Perry Fenwick and his family. The question is, do the Pickles know their onions?
Ah.
And the answer is yes, because so far it's no points to the Fenwick family. And in the lead with 275, it is the Pickles family. Matt and Lee, come and join me. We play the first round of Double Money. Come on, Lee. Matt, Lee, Matt.
Hello, hello.
One on by your buzzer.
One in there, yeah. Now one there, yeah.
Wicked. Right. Looking good, Lee, I tell you.
Thank you, mate. Nice. Thank
looking
you.
Sharp.
I make the effort for you. Because I'm against such small chaps, you know.
All right, here we go. Double Money. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top five answers. Name a famous ocean.
Pacific.
Name a famous ocean.
Pacific.
I can't get any more Pacific than that.
I'm afraid.
How long have you been at uni?
I work for a uni.
Oh, OK. Did you go to uni?
I did.
What did you study?
I studied history and politics.
Did you go to uni?
No.
Such is life! Let's have a look. Pacific. Yeah, cool. You've got to prove yourself now, Matt. So, if you can give me a famous ocean that's more popular than Pacific, then you'll get control of the board. What do you think, big guy?
Go for Atlantic.
Atlantic. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yeah, so far, good job. Can we play? All right. Lee, go back, join your family. Matt, you come and join yours. We're going to turn the screw on the Fenwick family. They've got no points. Lucy, what do you think? Name a famous ocean.
Indian.
Indian Ocean. Yeah, a lot of fans of the Indian Ocean in the in the studio tonight. Let's have a look. Our survey says.
Hey.
Yes, well done. You only need two more answers for the full board. You've got all three lives intact, Carolyn. Name a famous ocean.
I can't. I've gone completely blank. They're all seas, not oceans.
Caroline. Unfortunately, you were timed out, which means you have to get one of these. Lucky. Hetty, what do you think?
I was going to say Mediterranean, but I've just realised it's a sea. But Hawaiian? No, sorry.
It's not your favourite pizza.
I've got one in my head, but I can't think.
Lucky, two in a row. No one likes to see that. Unfortunately, Hetty, you get one of these. Two more answers. Jason, you're flying tonight. Come on.
Baltic.
Baltic. All right, let's have a look. If it's there, you're still in the game. If it's not, we're going to go to the Fenwick family and they're going to get the chance to steal. We're looking for the Baltic. Unlucky. Connor, what do you think?
Frank
Ocean, the singer. Lee?
Mediterranean.
Tracy?
Billy.
Billy Ocean. Diane?
Caribbean.
All right. Now then, Perry, you can have one of them or one of your own.
Come on, Pearl. Arctic.
All right. For the steal from the Pickles, you're saying the Arctic. Our survey says... Yeah! Let's take a look at that missing answer. Fourth most popular answer is... Billy Ocean! So, at the end of the first Double Money round, the scores are 184 to the Fenwick family and 275 to the Pickles family. It's still all to play for. Well done. Right, who'd have thought it's really come to this? It's come to the final round of Double Money. The Fenwicks have 184. The Pickles have 275. The winner of this final round of Double Money will go through to Big Money and their chance to play for £30,000. So let's welcome our fifth family members, Lucy and Connor, for the final round of Double Money. Lucy, Connor. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your backs. Good luck to you both. Here we go. Name somewhere you have to keep quiet. Lucy.
A library.
Well done.
Yes.
Well done. Good answer. We're looking for five. Is library one of them? Top answer. Important decision. Do you want to play or pass?
Play.
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 All right, they're confident. We're going to play. All right, Connor, go back to your family. Start conferring. You might get the chance to steal again to take your family through to big money. Now, Carolyn, what do you think? We're looking for four answers. You've got three lives. Name somewhere you have to keep quiet.
The theatre.
The theatre. From experience.
Oh, yes.
All right, well, let's have a look. At the theatre. All right, Hetty, what do you think?
I'm going to say church.
Church. Very nice. Yes. Church. Let's have a look. Our survey says. Yes. Very good. Very good. Jason, you've got to redeem yourself from your last answer.
I was going to say my girlfriend's bedroom, but. I got with a safe one.
Don't worry, it's fine.
I've got hopes for this young man, and it's all working out.
I'll play it safe and go with classroom.
Classroom. You're getting nothing for Christmas. Let's have a look. Our survey says. Matt. It's all come down to your hefty shoulders. If you don't give me an answer that's on the board, we're going to go over to the Fenwicks and they're going to get the chance to steal. What do you think, big fella?
I'll go with cinema, please, Vernon.
Cinema, yes, at the pictures. Yes, good answer. Good answer. Well done. Let's have a look. We're going for cinema. Yes! Well done, pal. Lucy, what do you think?
Can I say library again? A wedding. In a library. A wedding in a library.
I'll give you some advice.
Okay.
Right, let's go back to that scenario where you're now sat at home watching the show because this is pre-recorded.
Right.
Now, because of the first blooper that you made, all right. I suggest that you say to your friends, oh, and that's it, and we did ever so well, let's go out. Because, therefore, they won't get to see this bit.
Okay.
Where you made another big boo-boo for an hour now. Lucy. Just let's tell the nation again what your answer was.
A wedding.
In the library. I don't like being quiet at weddings. I like, you know, it's a celebration, isn't it? It's a unity, a bond of two people getting together.
Yes,
who've spent the whole life together, quiet in a bedroom. You know what I mean? All right, here we go. We're looking for a wedding. Our survey says. Oh, here we go!
I can't believe it.
At least you look good. Right, Connor, what do you think?
Funeral.
Lee?
Monastery, Vern.
Tracy?
Convent.
Diane?
Monastery.
All right, Perry, it's important. You can have one of them or you can have one of your own. If you get it right, you're going to go through to big money. If you get it wrong, it's the pickles that will play for 30 grand.
I'm going to go for funeral.
Funeral. Funeral. If it's there, you've stolen the points and you've quashed all the hard work that the Pickles family have done tonight because, I'll be honest with you, you have played so well as a family. If it is up there, you lot, unbelievable! We're looking for a funeral for the steal from the Pickles family. It's got to be one of the two missing answers. Is funeral on the board for the steal for the Fenwicks? Our survey says. Yeah! Wow, unbelievable. Let's take a look at that third most popular answer. It was. Hospital. Hospital, wow. At the end of the main game, the Pickles family have 275 points. But the winners of both double money rounds, making their score 332 points, are the Fenwick family. Give them a big round. You're going to be playing in our big money final, I can't believe it. But unfortunately, we've got to say goodbye to one of the best families we've ever had on Family Fortune. You've been amazing. You have been amazing. It's so difficult getting a full ball on the show, and you get two. So well done. Congratulations. Lucy, thank you so much for being rubbish. Really appreciate it. Really do. Give them a massive round of applause. But you don't go away empty-handed. You've got 275 points. We're going to times that by 10, giving you 2,750 pounds for your charity, which was, just remind us, please.
It's the Interact charity, which is a charity which helps rehabilitate stroke patients in hospitals. It's
very well done. Plus the prizes you picked up along the way. Martin was in Mexico. Enjoy that. And the mobile phone, Betty. Congratulations. Have you enjoyed yourself? Lucy, have you enjoyed yourself?
Yeah.
Good. Good. You've been a great family, like I said. It's excellent lovely. Stuff. Give a big round of applause. The Pickles. Harry.
Yes.
Harry, the pressure's on.
Yeah.
Now you've got to start playing for proper.
Okay.
All right. We're going to play our big money final. You're going to play because you're team captain.
Yeah.
You need someone to help you. Who are you going to choose?
My sister Tracy.
All right, Tracy. Perry, come down the front. Let's play big money. Well done, Tracy. After the break, we will play our big money final and the chance to win £30,000. We'll see you in a few. Welcome back. Now, before the break, we saw the Fenwick family win the main game, which means it's now their chance to win up to £30,000 for their charity. Now, Perry has gone backstage. You can't see or hear us, so Tracy and I are going to play big money. Good luck. Now, then, between you and Perry, you need to get 200 points. Do that, we'll give you £10,000. Get all five top answers, we'll give you 30 grand for your charity. Right. I'm going to ask you both five questions. You've got 15 seconds. Your time starts when I finish your first question.
Right.
Can't think of an answer, just say pass. If we've got time, we'll come to it at the end. Good luck. Can I have 15 seconds on the clock? Name a musical instrument beginning with the letter T.
Trombone.
Name another word for your stomach.
Belly.
Name something a skier needs.
Skis.
Name a boy's name that has only three letters.
Ben.
Name a shade of blue.
Turquoise.
Well done. Really good answers. All right, good luck, Tracy. Some really good answers. Let's have a look at the board. Remember, 200 points, 10,000 points, all five top answers will give you 30 grand. Name a musical instrument beginning with the letter T. You said trombone. Our survey said 39. Name another word for your stomach. You said
belly.
Our survey said 43. Well done, 82 already. Name something a skier needs. Hello. You said skis. Our survey said 47. Well done, 129. Name a boy's name that only has three letters. You said Ben. Our survey said 28. Got 157. Wow. Name a shade of blue. You said turquoise. Our survey said 11. Got 168. That's a fantastic score. Well done, Tracy. Go back, join your family. Let's clear the board and welcome back Perry. Here we go, Perry.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you the same five questions that I asked your Tracy.
Right.
But because it's a little bit more difficult, you've got an extra 5 seconds, so you've got 20 in total.
Okay.
Time starts when I finish the first question. Can't think of an answer, just say pass. We'll come back to it at the end if we've got time. And if you give me an answer that Tracy's already given me, you'll hear this noise, and I'll ask you for another answer. Good luck. Tracy got 168.
Poof!
Which means you only need 32 points, Perry, wow, for £10,000. Don't mess it up.
Well done.
She did really well. She did really, really well.
Right, okay.
Can I have 20 seconds on the clock? And can we remind the viewers at home of Tracy's answers? Good luck, Perry. Name a musical instrument beginning with the letter T.
Trumpet.
Name another word for your stomach.
Belly. Guts.
Name something a skier needs.
Goggles.
Name a boy's name that only has three letters.
Ian.
Name a shade of blue. A shade of
sky
blue.
Sky blue.
That's very good look. Remember, like I said, 200 points, £10,000, or 5 top answers will give you 30 grand. There you go, 168. She did phenomenally.
Yeah.
Really, really well. Here we go. Name a musical instrument beginning with the letter T. You said a trumpet. Our survey said. Yeah! You did it on the first answer. We've got £10,000. That's your money. That is banked. Wow. Now what we want is all 5 top answers for £30,000. Trombone got 39. Was trombone the top answer? Yes, excellent. Name another word for your stomach. You said... your guts. Our survey said... 18. Wow. That doesn't matter. That's irrelevant. We're looking for those 5 top answers. Was belly the top answer? Name something a skier needs. You said goggles. Our survey said 10. Ski's got 47. Surely that's got to be a top answer. Yes, well done. Well done. Name a boy's name that has only 3 letters. You said Ian. Our survey said oh, 10. Ben only got 28. Is Ben with 28 enough to be a top answer? Our survey said... Yeah! Well done. Well done. All right, let's come down to this. Name a shade of blue. It's a tough question. Name a shade of blue. You said... sky. Our survey said... oh. 23. What charity are you playing for? You've already won £10,000.
Cancer research.
Cancer research, all right. Sky only got 23, but is 23 enough to be a top answer? The 5th and final top answer for £30,000 for cancer research. Our survey says... yeah! Just won a family fortune of £30,000, Perry. For your charity, Cancer Research, well done, well done. And you picked up those prizes from earlier. You got the supercar experience. Well done, Connor. Wow, how are you feeling?
Blown away, absolutely blown away.
Do you know
away.
What? I can't believe it. After the way you played earlier on, it was truly shocking. But it just goes to show, it doesn't matter. You won £30,000 for your charity. Well done, Perry. You've been a fab family. Give it up for the Fenwick family. So big thanks to both of our families. Join us next time when we play more Family Fortunes. Good night.
Coming up next time on All-Star Family Fortune.
Nadia Sawala! Jen Cox!
There's nothing I don't know about Delicious Baby.
The hobbity hobbity hop hop.
Oh, my word.
See you then.
Oh, I love this show.